for you are faithful till the end.
May the flavor that comes.
You have made my future possible. Bigger than the biggest, yet you live in me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Good evening, dear brothers and sisters in Christ.
Amen.
We are glad to say thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Lord. We are glad to glorify the Lord. We are glad to worship the Lord. We are glad to adore Him. We are glad to praise Him for all He has done for us. We cannot thank Him enough. We cannot appreciate Him enough. You feel God has not done anything for you, go to the hospital. You feel you have no reason to thank Him, remember that you are not in a sick bed. You are not in the hospital. You are not in the grave. Many are in their sick bed. Many older than you and younger than you are in the grave. But God has protected you in spite of the siege of last year. Because of COVID-19, the lockdown, so everything was shut. In spite of the struggle, in spite of the suffering that people passed through, many died because of the COVID, the sickness, and so on, hunger. But then, God still preserved you to this moment. We have all the reason to appreciate Him. In that way, if you are happy, do something for Jesus.
That today the grace of God
we shed upon them and bring them into a light of joy, both now and forevermore. Brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate what is the sacred mystery, let us acknowledge that we are sinners. Walk before Him in His throne of mercy and ask for forgiveness. Ask for mercy. Ask for pardon. That you be worthy and great enough to receive the grace that He bestowed on us.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who taught the whole world through the preaching of the blessed Apostle Paul, draw us, we pray, near unto you through the example of him whose conversion we celebrate today, and so make us witnesses to your truth in the world. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, ever and ever.
Deliverance.
your breakthrough.
Are you happy?
He's not talking about we are in pain. We go to Jesus and say, do something new in my life. Something new in my life. And when he has done that something new, you don't remember him again. But behave like people, when they are in need, they go to Jesus and say, do something new in my life. And when that something new in their life begins to happen, they change the music in self-independence. And when God begins to do something new again, because he has seen you happy for the little he has done for you, he will do a greater one and the music will change.
Servants. At field time, Boaz said to Ruth, and what was the most day bring to her. She ate until she was satisfied, and she still had some food left over.
It's okay. That's it. 14. Praise the Lord. May God bless His word in our heart, both now and forevermore. Praise the Lord. And so it seems so sweet. Abi, the story seems sweet. If you look at chapter 1, the last part of it, you will see how Ruth was returning, Naomi and Ruth were returning from the foreign land where they went for greener pasture. Although they were already wealthy in Bethlehem, before they traveled out. After the country, of course, we are familiar with the story of Ruth and Naomi. Everything turned around. She lost the husband. The two sons of Christ died, leaving behind the wives. And the mother now says to the in-laws, the thousand months, please go back to your parents. There's nothing we can do again. One left, and Ruth said, wherever you go, I'll go with you. Praise the Lord. Wherever you go, I'll go with you. I cannot leave you behind. And when they were returning, the last verse in chapter 1, he said it was at the beginning of the harvest. That's when they came back to Bethlehem. At the beginning of the harvest. Because of the famine in one where they were before. Consequently, when they experienced the spirit of famine. So things became difficult, extremely difficult, that they can no longer survive there, or she could no longer survive there. She thought of going back home. What else can I do? It's better to go back home and die my people, among my people, where they can see my corpse and bury it, than die of hunger and starvation in a foreign land. So they journey back home. And they arrived home. People who knew her very well, look at her coming back home destitute, tattered, like an old, what we call an old witch. You know, when a woman is old, when see a woman old and she no longer dresses very well, automatically that woman is a witch. True or false? False. Amen. You see an old woman in the village struggling to survive. Don't begin to say that they lose, then they can be like that. Whether true or not, that is the mentality of us Africans and Nigerians. Many a times we see people who are old as bad ones. So she came back, no longer worldly, as she went when she went. Now, destitute, begging for food to eat and survive, become the problem. I'm saying, is that not Naomi? She said, do not call me Naomi. Naomi means sweet, pleasant, wonderful, something that is good, just like being precious. Do not call me Naomi, call me Mara. Mara means bitter. Because my life is no longer precious, my life is no longer sweet. I am bitter now. And not only that, I am bitter because the Lord has testified against me. And the Almighty God has gone against me. She started complaining about God. Because things have turned around. And that is always the case. When things turn around on any of us or anybody, there's a tendency that we start complaining about God. Do I not pray every day? I go to church every time. I pray to God. I don't miss my rules in a day. I have never missed Mass. Those who have the gift of healing, say, God has blessed me. I pray for people and they recover. I pray for people and they have breakthrough. I pray for people and they experience success. Why is my own life different? Those who have the gift of singing, who keep complaining, I will not sing for you again. All this time I've been doing all the things that you have not seen, it's not enjoying it. I will sing and even the dead rise from the grave, but from them, and yes. And then, because it's not more stress, they put them away. God brought them back at the time, at the beginning of harvest. And then, before a good day, they woke up in the morning, nothing to eat. Who said, Mama, make our carnal culture and not go any far past. Whoever favors me, make I do the same thing and drink that as well, you can eat and survive. Nobody will have no option. Say, okay, go ahead, move on. Resilience. Move it. In our sight today, everything is about union. Don't be so. Everything is about union. You go this way, you are registered. Are you registered as well as you? Are you a member? You go this way, in the market they have union. At the farm they have union. Everywhere they have union. In the farm, union. So at this time, something let's see that they have union of widows who were living in the farm. She entered the farm. First they said, you are not one of us, please leave us alone. As you leave to another one, when the same thing will happen, we do not know you. Look at her, you cannot even understand her now. Please, you are not even a member of one of us. You don't even belong to this community. Please go. So the same thing they see that she must have been wandering around looking for where to go. Unfortunately for her, she entered the farm of Boaz. Boaz happened to be a relation to Naomi and a very wealthy man. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Now is the beginning of favor, the beginning of blessing, the beginning of breakthrough, the beginning of change in the lives of Ruth and Naomi. She entered the farm of Boaz and pleaded with the chief harvester, the manager in the life, please help me. Let me just gather behind the ones that are harvesting in front of the ground. Oh, I said, no problem. Go ahead. And she joined the harvester. Boaz came back or came in, entered the farm, and noticed a foreign person in his farm. He did not see that man. There were many other women and young girls there. But he was able to pick out Ruth. Who is that young girl? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Who is that young woman there? And very beautifully, the manager went and picked her by the hand. Praise the Lord. And took her straight to Boaz, the CEO. Praise the Lord. I don't think the CEO. She's the executive officer. Took her by the hand, the manager. See, she never write an application for a job. You did not beg. And now the manager went to beg, carry you by the hand. Go meet the CEO and introduce you to the CEO. He's a happy company guy here. Praise the Lord. That's what it means when you walk in God's favor. When the grace of God is upon your life, and a wrong person will meet you by the hand and introduce you to the CEO, and the CEO will favor you. Amen. This was the beginning of the story. Remember, God was about to favor them. But they felt God has abandoned them. They felt that nothing works out again. Remember, Naomi told them, do not call me Naomi. Call me Martha. Call me Peter. Because my life is bitter. Somebody's life is bitter. The situation that you find yourself, you feel nothing works out again. All hope is gone. There is no change again. And your enemy will tell you, they have buried your destiny. And there is no two ways about it again. The case is closed. I said, alive. Praise the Lord. They felt Daniel's case was over. Is it not? They felt Daniel's case was over. That nobody can change the case. That the matter is closed. They threw him inside the lion's den and covered the pit. Praise God. Praise the Lord. They threw him again inside the lion's den and covered the pit as if they had buried him there. Lion, the finisher. The old case, not finished. But God made something happen that instead of lion finishing down it, they became his security. and Zion became Daniel's security. And not only that they became Daniel's security, I can imagine one of them lying and said, Daniel, makes me put your head in my body. Amen.
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 When your enemy accuses you, do not worry. When people gossip about you, do not worry, because they are announcing you. They are announcing you for something great. They are introducing you to the owner of the world. Do not be troubled. No. We'll go down a little further. This announcement will not come. Remember, Boaz did not know Ruth. When he entered the farm, he said, who is that young woman? They said, the daughter of the daughter-in-law of Naomi, the daughter of then the story. And that very instant, praise the Lord. Let me see if we come to that place. Take a read that before I talk about it. Boaz said to Ruth, listen, my daughter. Basically, never know before, you don't become a daughter. Listen, my daughter, do not go anywhere from here. Make her go for a little bit upper, where the chief pharmacist, the manager, was doing the introduction. She came this morning and asked me to bring behind the harvesters. Since then, she has been working without a moment's rest. That is the word he used to introduce Ruth to the master, telling him that this young woman is hardworking. This young woman is diligent. This young woman is good. She's a wonderful woman. She can serve me very well. Praise God. At that very moment, Boaz said, Ruth, listen, my daughter, do not go anywhere. Stay here. Do not go anywhere to anyone else's farm. Stay here with my women servants. See where the harvesters are. I follow behind. I have ordered the men not to molest you. They have filled some jars with water. Go there and drink when you are thirsty. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Tell your person, tell me sometimes, somebody will announce you. Somebody will announce you for greatness. Somebody will introduce you. Somebody will introduce you for something greater. Those of the overflow, can I hear you say somebody will introduce you? Somebody will introduce you. Somebody who never knew you will announce you. And you will find favor with God. Because you are walking with God. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Come for Jesus. After the introduction, Boaz said, stay. What did he say? What did he say? Hey, who is looking for employment here? Who is looking for employment here? Automatic employment will locate you. Automatic employment will locate you. The favor of Ruth will be your own favor. Praise God. This is automatic employment. Stay here. Go nowhere again. Walk with my women. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Automatic employment. It's not ended with employment. We borrow allowance. Full allowance. Free accommodation. Praise the Lord. Stay with my women servant. See where they are best. Join them in the work. I have ordered men. men not to molest you. I have ordered men not to molest you. I have ordered. They have filled some jars with water. Go there and drink. Praise the Lord. Praise the living God. God is so sweet. God is so wonderful. And those who walk with him will say he's favor. And those who walk with him will say he's favor. Just imagine Ruth and Naomi that came back destitute, going begging, without application. She got free appointments with Rorup allowance, free accommodation, free food, and now what? Security and silence. People will feel wonder for you. Go there and beg. Somebody shout hallelujah. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Amen. You shall find favor with God. You shall find favor with God. And because you are walking in God's favor, the blessing of Ruth will be your blessing. The favor of Ruth will be your favor. The grace that God gave to Ruth will follow you. It never ends here. It's just like a introduction. Ruth has been given appointments with everything trained. And still, Boaz was not still satisfied. He was not still okay. He started showering blessing on Ruth. But then Ruth bowed down with face to the ground. She exclaimed, "Why have I, a foreigner, found such favor in your eyes that you should notice me?" Boaz answered, "I have been told about you, what you have done for your mother-in-law since her husband's death." Praise the Lord. This is the point of the announcements. I have been told about you. Amen. The question I asked when I read this portion of the Bible, I said, who told him? Are we together? This is somebody you came in and you are seeing her for the first time. Who told him about Ruth? When he never knew it. Amen. 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 At this point, you start and see what people can do. Gossip. Probably people have been gossiping and mentioning who's doing what they might go to the person. Maybe those who have seen her in the farm earlier on and they keep talking, they are trying to spoil the image of Ruth. They are trying to spoil the mind of God about Ruth, to destroy the identity of Ruth, so that nobody will think anything good about her. She was a young girl whose husband died, and she came back with a mother-in-law, still very young. As that tells us, some people might have said, "Oh, look at this stupid girl. Maybe you don't go find a husband. What my person is this woman? She's a crazy woman. Nobody. Better go and find you, go marry her." So a lot must have been said about Ruth through gossip. People must have criticized her actions. So I said, stupid. And this must have entered the ear of Boaz. I say, because Boaz is sensitive and sensible, and God's favor was upon Ruth, and the grace of God also reached Boaz. I said, let's ask a question to know what is happening. And of all that these people have said about Ruth, before Boaz finally entered the farm, when he entered the farm and made the food, now his own trusted manager carried him by the hand and introduced him with good image. Praise the Lord. And speak good about image, about Ruth, something contrary to what he has said. And they were trying to destroy the image of Ruth. And God was still in a positive. positive way. God will change every negative thought about you into positive. God will change every negativity into positivity. Every story will transform to glory. Every disappointment will become appointments. Every promotion in your life will transform to promotion. Change things in the life of Ruth and Naomi. They will gossiping her, destroying her name, destroying her image. May God change all those things into positive and pass everything into a positive way and bless those. I have made a complete account of you, how you bless your village and follow your mother in law to this place. You will be blessed. I am out to favor you. Everything shall work out for you. Just remain here because the grace of God is upon you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Because the grace of God is upon your life. This year you shall receive God's favor. Because the grace of God follows you. That grace that brought you out of 2020 into 2021 with good strength and life in you, that grace will lead you through to your destination. That grace will help you locate your destiny. That grace will lead you from nowhere and nobody to somewhere and become somebody. The foreign land and brought her back, even though she may not have will or desire, it might be against her will, it might be against her decision. The God brought her back to achieve her destiny. The grace of God will lead you, the grace of God will direct you to your destination, and then you achieve your destiny. The grace of God will lead you to your glory. Against your will, then because you are here, because the favor of God is upon you, God will direct your steps, God will direct your choice, God will direct your ways, God will direct your thoughts, and you will walk into your glory. And then somebody shout hallelujah. Clap for Jesus. The story of Joseph is very familiar to everybody. Very, very familiar. The story of Joseph, the story of Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These are wonderful stories. Joseph and Daniel suffered. They don't just take that of Joseph a little. Started with the brothers as a young boy. He was a dreamer. And he tells the brothers a dream. And the brothers became angry and they hated him. Not just that the father loved him because of his dreams. He became a problem. And as a young boy, he didn't even understand the dreams. He was happy. They sold him out to the house of Midianites, to the house of Potiphar. The house of Potiphar. Before God was stopped on him, when the bride of Potiphar became a thorn on his face, he became a problem. And from there, he was sent to prison. One beautiful thing, take note of this. One beautiful thing, somebody who was accused as a slave, as a servant, he was accused and thrown to prison. They don't put him in a prison where other slaves were. They put him in a royal prison. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You know, even though the senator has committed a crime and has taken the prison, he cannot be in the same prison where a common criminal is put. Hope you know that. If he's in the prison, he cannot be in the same prison where common criminals on the street and kidnappers will be taken to. So if that was prison that Joseph was put in the same prison, that type of prison the senator will be put. But he was a slave. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
authority put in
place. You see power favor with best force in charge of business. And a best in charge of our business. Inside the prison, Joseph will receive the gifts or discover his gift of interpretation of dreams. Praise the Lord. Joseph, in the prison, will receive or discover that he had the gift of interpretation of dreams without knowing. There, it was made manifest. And with that gift that manifested Joseph in prison, he interpreted the dreams of the cupbearer and became a beggar, chief beggar. And the dream came true. 2 years later, Pharaoh had a dream, and Joseph was remembered. And they went and brought Joseph out of prison, and he interpreted the dream for Pharaoh in Egypt. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And just listen to how God is changing things from negativity into positivity. How God is changing people's story into glory. How God is changing people's disappointment into appointment. Joseph suffers. You are suffering, that God has appointed you. God may be indirectly leading you to your glory, and you feel that you are suffering. It's not always the case. When Joseph interpreted a dream for Pharaoh, wow, something happened. Praise the Lord. Something did what? Something did what? A slave became a king. Amen.
Amen.
A slave became what?
Amen.
A king. Praise the Lord. Praise God for Jesus. Not only that he became a king, because he never said something is that kings, you have to become a king in your own kingdom. But now, a slave became a king in a foreign land without obeying transport to the foreign land. Praise the Lord. Joseph became a king in Egypt without paying transport to Egypt. Please, we will clap for Jesus. Somebody from story to glory. God will change your story. God will wipe your tears. And now God is with Esther. I bet I'm moving time again. Praise the Lord. With Esther was a slave, an orphan, and she became a queen, still in a foreign land. The grace of God will shower upon somebody, and God will change your situation. The grace of God will come upon you, and God will change your condition. The grace of God will come upon you, and everything about you will change.
Let me show. Let's touch. Let me show.
Amen. those who are sick in the root of the womb. All those sick in the root of the womb, just put your hand in your stomach. The power of God will touch you. The power of God will bless you. The power of God will bring breakthrough in your life. That whatever is tying that hope down, whatever is constraining that hope, that anytime you conceive, you have established. And sometimes you are even unable to conceive that the creation of God will send His Holy Spirit to untie that hope and make that hope better. And the power of God repels everything that the devil has projected into that hope. That is always there to destroy every facility that comes in. That the power of the Holy Spirit will make that hope better. That the God who made the sinner conceive in our own age. The God who made the sinner conceive in our own age. The God who made the father conceive in our own age. Who will make you conceive in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Every one of